Mangroves is the name for a special kind of vegetation associated with intertidal areas of sea coast. They are found in shallow parts of estuarial and backwater of the coast. Most plants of the mangroves ecosystems are woody, being trees or shrubs. These plants are unique because they can live in places too salty for normal plants. The basal part of the most mangrove species are submerged by high tides. During the low tides, the water level recedes, exposing the mangrove plants almost entirely, standing on soft water logged clay or muddy soils. The Honavara Forest Department in Karnataka over the last few years has been promoting mangrove afforestation. The green lining along the fringes of the coastline bear testimony to the effort of Honavara Forest Department. They have involved in local people to plant as well as protect the mangroves.
Honavara division is rich in evergreen and semi-evergreen forests. Also in Honavara Forest division there are four important rivers joining the Arabian Sea. It extends between Bhatkal in the south to Ankola in the north. We have got important rivers like Aganashini, Gangavali, Venkatapura and Sharavati. In these river and estuaries, we have got potential mangrove habitat. But the mangrove are dwindling day by day because of various biotic pressures like encroachment, fishing, sand quarrying, etc. There were no concentrated efforts to restore mangroves till recently. Right from 2000-2001 onwards, we have started efforts in restoring mangroves by motivating the local people, creating awareness and taking up artificial regeneration of mangrove species.
The Karnataka government has funded mangrove restoration project up to 2005 and 2006. The Japan Bank of International Cooperation has approved on a model in Karnataka Sustainable Forest Conservation and Biodiversity Project. They have included the mangrove as one of the major afforestation model which stretches for 8 years. The mangroves have physiological ability to cope up with salinity. They absorb salt water freely, but some of the mangroves secrete excess of salts through their leaves. The mangroves have spectacular aerial roots of varied kinds. In some trees, these roots look like vertical props or pillars. In some other, as in Rhizophora, they grow slantingly from base of the stem into the slushy soil like stilts. In Avicennia and Sonoraceae, the roots stick out of the mud into the air like pointed rods. These roots are full of small pores, which help in oxygenation of below soil part of the root system.
Mangrove ecosystem is the world's highest productive ecosystem in terms of fish, prawns, bivalves, crabs, and various kinds of organisms thrive in the mangrove ecosystem. So that is why the mangrove areas are very densely populated by human beings. So mangroves cater to the livelihoods of millions of people. See, the mangrove leaves are very rich in nutrients, and the leaves fall in the marsh, in this swampy area, and become food for various kinds of animals. And if we have more mangroves, there will be better fisheries.
Mangroves, because of their network of aerial routes, become a very effective protection for the shores. This network traps the soil and silt from the land and also filters and clarifies water. The shore protection from mangroves is much more efficient than from stone walls.
Mangrove andre kanla nedutopininda nadi dande melina savakaliyo tadegattutade allade tsunami teregalinda baruva anahutagalannu dandeya melina janarige adrinda rakshisutade murinadagi nanedu meenugalige paushtika aharanu odisutade.
People of coastal Karnataka are not very aware of uses of mangroves. Mangrove trees are rich sources of tannin for tanning of leather. Many mangrove trees are good producers of honey and can promote beekeeping. Avicennia leaves are rich in proteins and can make good fodder. Mangroves like Excoceria and Derris are used as fish poisons. Derris and Barringtonia are sources of bioinsecticides. Rhizophoria is known to have mosquito repelling properties. Bark powder of Candelia is used for treating diabetes. Poultice of Avicennia seeds heals ulcer and boils. The mangrove herb Acanthus is excellent manure for coconut.
Mangrove areas are very rich in bird life. As far as coastal North Canada is concerned, about 160 species of birds are reported from mangroves. At least 50% of them are visitors from northern countries like Russia, China, Mongolia, etc.
In coastal Karnataka, major cause for decline of mangroves in the early days was expansion of agriculture. During the last two decades, intensification of shrimp farming resulted in complete wiping out of mangroves from vast areas. Pollution, siltation and dumping of urban waste into backwaters have also aggravated mangrove destruction. Mangroves are useful to human and ecosystems in several ways, yet they are on the decline. The Karnataka Forest Department over the last few years have been promoting mangroves afforestation.
Artificial regeneration of the mangroves are being taken up on the Aghanashini river banks by introducing the propagules of the rhizophoras and the seedlings of Sonaraceae and Avicennias raised in the polythene bags. These seedlings are planted in the pits dug up on the river banks.
Mangrove seedlings are easily available from the trees and swamps. They can be planted directly in suitable intertidal areas of backwaters. Seeds of some species can be germinated in nurseries, and when the seedlings are ready, they can be planted in the swamps.
Even the 2-3 years ago, now the rhizophora species are now ಗಿಡಗಳನ್ನು ನೆಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ಈ ಸಾಧಾರಣ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ ಏಪ್ರಿಲ್ ಮೇ ತಿಂಗಳಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಅದರಲ್ಲೇನು ಕೋಡು ಬರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಬೆಳೆದಂಥ ಕೋಡುಗಳನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಒಂದು ಮೀಟ್ರ್ ಅಂತರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಅಲ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಗಿಡಗಳು ಹಾಳಾಗಿದೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಖಾಲಿ ಪ್ಯಾಚ್ಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ ಅಂಥ ಜಾಗಗಳನ್ನು ಮತ್ತು ಸಿಲ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಂಥ ಜಾಗಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ನೀರು ಹೋಗುವ ಜಾಗಗಳನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ನೆಟ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಒಂದೆರಡು ತಿಂಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಚಿಗುರಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ.
Village Forest Committee has been working towards awareness program, disseminating information about plantation and safeguarding it.
The formation of VFCs, that is Village Forest Committees, ensures the participation of the local community, for which the local communities are being provided with employment, and the under entry point activities we are providing the fishermen community with the fishing nets and constructing jetties for their easy communication. And natural regeneration is ensured by giving protection, and artificial regeneration by raising the seedlings in the nurseries and then planting in the main field.
Cattle grazing, passage of boats, casting of fishing nets, etc. can be ruinous to the young plantations.
ನಾವು ಗ್ರಾಮ ಅರಣ್ಯ ಸಮಿತಿ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಿಂದ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನಿಂದ ಬಂದ ಧನ ಸಹಾಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವು ಕಾಮಗಾರಿ ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಗಿದೆ. ಅದೇ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಕಾಂಡ್ಲಾ ಯೋಜನೆ ಕೂಡ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ನಮಗೆ ಇದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮೊದಲು ತಿಳುವಳಿಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇತ್ತು. ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನವರು ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಲಾಖೆಯವರು ಬಂದು ನಮಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸಿ ಹೇಳಿ ಈ ಕಾಂಡ್ಲಾ ಗಿಡವನ್ನು ನೆಟ್ಟರೆ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಉಪಯೋಗ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ತಿಳಿಸಿ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ಜನರಿಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಆ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅದು ಅವರು ಆಸಕ್ತಿಯಿಂದ ಅವರು ಈಗ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
Roping in the local people in safeguarding the mangroves has resulted in a moment of a kind.
I appeal to the people, particularly the fishermen community, to join hands with the forest department in conserving this highly endangered and threatened mangrove habitat in Karnataka.
A people's movement to harness nature so that both mankind and nature can exist in harmony. It's a movement that promotes a symbiotic relationship between man and nature.